Hey, Blues fans, it's Anthony from Texas Blues Alley. It's Free Lesson Friday, taking a look at kind of the syncopated turnaround that Stevie would play in the song Rude Mood. A couple of things before we start. I am in E-flat tuning because that's the tuning of the regular song. We're going to be playing in the key of E-flat in the open position here. And if you're a member of our membership program, the TXBA Locals, then you should be watching this on the site because you'll have access to tablature and a little jam track to help you practice this. I'm not going to lie, this song is tough. My favorite thing to say about it is even when you're playing it right, you're probably still wrong. But nonetheless, we're going to take a look at that turnaround and how to get that syncopated feel. So let's get into it. So you'll notice from the demonstration that I'm playing it quite a bit slower than what he actually did on the album. On the album, I think it's somewhere around 260 beats per minute or 286 or something. It's really fast. And it's very hard to get that chunk-a-chunk syncopated feel, so I've slowed it down to a more modest 220. That makes the rest of the song sound slow, but it makes it possible to get the and distinctly hear all of the different syncopated beats in there. So let's talk about what we're doing and how we transform this into something a little bit more country syncopated quacky. You know, I don't even know what the right adjectives do. It just sounds really cool. So the foundation of what we're doing is that we're taking this five chord seventh variation, which is this little triad, second fret of the A string, first fret of the D string, and then second fret of the G string, throwing in the high E string at the second fret. At the core of what we're doing is we're playing that, sliding it up one fret, back down, before we finish out with... All right, but obviously he's not... Let's talk about the picking rhythm. It's hard to hear at the full speed of the song, but when you slow it down, when you hear Stevie play it at slower speeds from live shows, you can hear a distinct swing in his rhythm. That gets harder to hear as the song gets faster, but if you take that rhythm you can hear a little bit of that syncopation starting to develop there, but obviously playing the full chord doesn't have the right feel. So the resulting sound that we get, that kind of back and forth syncopated sound, comes from using that rhythm, raking some notes, playing single notes out of those chords, and leaving spaces at other spots. So I'm going to teach it to you first, playing on every beat. And then I'm going to show you how to leave some spaces in there to make it sound even a little bit more funky. So let's talk about the first part. I want you to forget about this full chord and just focus on the second note of the A string, second note of the G string, or second fret of those strings, and the second fret of the E string. Hit on the low A, on the A string of the second fret, followed by two rakes, then the second fret of the G string, followed by one rake, then the high E string of the second fret, followed by a rake. Okay, a little bit tricky. Okay, it's not. It's A string, two rakes, G string, one rake, D string, one rake. Okay, now what comes next is a slide. Two to three on A string. and the third string of the G string, third fret of the G string, and two rakes. Then down to the second fret of the A string and up to the second fret of the E string. And two rakes. Okay? So work on that, strumming on every beat. It's either a rake or a note. And what you end up with is... Do that again, one more time, a little bit slower. Okay, now that is hard enough to play at full speed, but we're going to make it even more complicated by leaving out some of the rakes. All of the notes that we play are going to stay the same, but we're going to leave some spaces at some other spots to give it a little bit more of a hiccuping sound. So this part is the same. But instead of the rake between this, we're going to leave that rake out. So no rake in between this note and this note. First we played. Now we're going to play. And we're just going to let this note ring out a little bit more. But then we go right back into our main rhythm. We got the rake after this note. Right into our walk up. And here's where we leave our next space. And this one's even harder. Because the two rakes that followed this note feel very natural. So when we leave the first one out, what we're left with is... But listen to this compared to this. That one sounds like it has a little bit more of a hiccup in it. So again, just to be very clear, what we're leaving out, normally two rakes followed that, but now we're going to skip the first one and play it silent. And go back to what we were doing before. So those are the two spaces that we leave. Right there. And right here. And then to finish it out, open twice, roll from 3 to 4, second fret of the A string twice, fourth fret of the A string twice, second fret of the D string, open, second fret of the A string, and then try it. All right, so practice this at whatever tempo you have to get to work on, to get those little rakes and spaces in there, and then gradually speed it up. If you can't get it to sound right at the full speed that the track is recorded at, don't worry. I can't even do that. That's part of the reason I slowed it down for this lesson. But that sound that you hear him play so effortlessly, that syncopated kind of, you know, sounds like a hiccup in the middle of the rhythm, that comes from that pattern, notes of the chord combined with rakes, combined with spaces. And that combination of things, that's syncopation right there. That's giving you kind of a rhythm within the rhythm. And something that tormented me for years, and then when I slowed it down, I realized it's just not that complicated. It just requires developing the muscle memory to know when to hit at different beats and when to be silent. So anyway, I hope that's as useful to me as, I hope you're excited to learn that as I was when I figured it out. And until next time, thanks for watching.